The spending plan, in fact, identifies all of the myriad line items in the state budget and how much money we're willing, we being the General Assembly, is willing to spend on each of those line items. So the budget does not do a lot of damage this year, is one way for me to put it. Does not do a lot of damage, particularly to those line items that have to do with aging and human services, as well as health and drug and alcohol. That part is good news, but how we pay for it, which is absolutely integral. So we've decided, if you will, what our shopping list will be, but now we have to figure out how to pay for it, and we need real money to do that. And next week, that debate will start and continue in earnest. Some of us, of course, would like to see even more dollars dedicated to things like high quality pre-K, toward basic education, so that our future workforce is off to a very, very good start even now. But the dollars that are in there are certainly adequate. Our growth in Pennsylvania has not been as robust as we would like to see it. We do have a structural deficit that is north of $1 billion and a bit of a shortfall of revenue for this year that ends today. So next week's discussion about how we pay for it becomes even more critical, because if this is not based on sustainable and recurring revenue, then we can be short again next year for next year's budget.